Hey, welcome back to Fresh Out Live. I'm Kevan Kenney, and my guest today is a platinum hitmaker who burst onto the scene with a presence and performance that put the industry on notice. She's joined an iconic list of MCs from her home borough, but you can't spell Brooklyn without Brooke. Welcome Lola Brooke back to Fresh Out Live.
What's up?
What's going on? Fresh off the, we were just talking, the BET Hip Hop Awards, and
yes.
Now you're trying to, I'm a fan of yours, but now I'm like, I don't know how to feel. You're trying to take my job being a red carpet host.
I mean, I could co-host with you. I ain't trying to take your job now. I'm always be a rapper, you know? I ain't trying to do that.
How was that experience?
It was scary, exciting at the same time. I remember being on a platform and just saying to myself, why did I say yes to this gig? It was, the lights were so bright, so it felt like so much attention is on you, but it's a good feeling once it's over. I wish I could do it all over again.
So is that something you'd like to do?
Yes, it was a good feeling.
Yeah.
To be an artist and then get to do something else as a side gig, you know?
Yeah,
it was
there
cool.
You go. Totally. Was there something that surprised you that was harder or easier than you realized going in?
No. Honestly, I didn't overthink it.
Yeah.
I didn't overthink it, but once I got there, I knew for a fact that this was something that, like, I couldn't imagine doing. Like, I didn't, like, oh, it was just crazy.
Well, you did a great job.
Thank you.
We are here to talk about a very exciting record of yours that is out right now with Jeremih, No One Else.
No One Else, yeah.
And it's perfect for cuffing season. It kind of arrived at the perfect time.
Yes.
And talk to me about just how the record came to be and working with Jeremih.
Oh, Jeremih, he's so lit. And he's so calm, and he's just so fun, and he reminds me that regardless of being an artist, you're still a human being, so don't put too much pressure on yourself. That's why I had to put the pressure on the song. And his vocals put the pressure on the song as well, and it's getting chilly outside, so it was only right that I put Jeremih on the record.
Definitely. And you also, I think, are, with this record, continuing this great lineage, at least as me as a New York City hip-hop fan, of every New York City great hip-hop artist, in my opinion, they've done what you've done with this record, right? Where you come in with the attitude, the bravado, right, of Brooklyn, and then you show us the softer side. You know, you think of like a 50 with 21 Questions, or, you know, what LL did back in the day, of course, taking it all the way back. And now you're doing it.
I'm happy you said 50 Cent because he's definitely a great example. He's one of my favorites. And this is the thing about New Yorkers. I know we give tough love, but we still love, you know? We still want to be affectionate. We still want to feel wanted. And it's so easy to tap into that space for me because I am Aquarius. You know, month of February, that's Valentine's Day month, and it's about love. So I can't run from love even if I wanted to.
I think what's most exciting about No One Else is it shows off a totally different side of Lola Brooke to the fans, the softer side. So what has inspired this soft girl era that is upon us?
I ain't going front. Like I said, it's getting cold. I won't be mad if I leave here and I could go home and go cuddle. Yeah, so I'm searching, baby. I'm searching for no one else but you. If you out there, holla at me.
I didn't know if Lola was talking to the people on set or you at home, so there you go.
Well, whoever want to take the bait.
Aquarius season is fast approaching. Now, you've taken some time this year. You talked about this with your fans, and I think this is great and really healthy, and you're a great example for doing this. This work-life balance that I think everyone needs to find, this work-life balance where you've kind of gotten to know yourself a little bit better as an artist. What has that taught you? What has that journey been like?
I won't say hectic because I asked for this. But I will say it's been challenging, but I know that when you bump into challenges, that just means that you're growing and it's a good cause. But I just learned balancing everything out is the most important thing that you can do as a human being and an artist at the same time.
Yeah, and I think when you're wrapped up in the whirlwind and you have so much success like you have, you forget sometimes, well, you got to live a little life.
You got
to
live
a little. You got something to talk about on the record,
yeah.
No?
You gotta go out to the club or something.
Right?
You gotta have a little argument with your friends sometimes. Agree to disagree.
You gotta get some cuddles.
You gotta get some cuddles.
From time to time.
Yeah.
That's all we're saying. Now, you also did a very cool thing, the VMA's block party here, which thank you very much for doing that. That was great.
Thank you for having me. I had so much fun.
That was so cool. And that was in Brooklyn, was it not?
Yes, it was in Brooklyn.
That had to be so cool. Hometown show with MTV. What was that like?
Spread love is the Brooklyn way. The people's was... One thing I can't say about New York City, when the people of New York City vibe with you, you're never gonna lose. So to be in my hometown and just performing for the people, I just felt really great.
Yeah. And now you're fast at work on the next project, of course. What can you tell us? What can we expect? And people watching MTV from this new project you're working on?
Okay, so I dropped Dinner's Daughter last year, and this year I'm gearing up for the top of the year to drop some new heat. And what I can say is that with this project, I could say I'm in the space of actually knowing who Lola Brooke is. I already know who Shanice is, of course, but I have a better understanding of who Lola Brooke is, and I'm just excited to share with the world.
Well, we've seen both sides of you now, right?
Yeah.
Which is really cool. So I think we're going to get a three-dimensional Lola Brooke at the top of 25, it sounds like.
Yeah.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah, that's what's going to go on.
I'm very excited. I know everyone else is watching MTV. Lola, thank you so much for stopping by. And for you watching Fresh Out Live, be sure to check out and stream No One Else from Lola out now.